Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. Today we are going to talk about a very important and useful tip. In Google Sheets, we can import our email data to our Google Sheets and copy paste it with the help of script. Okay, so what we are going to do it today is we are writing a script today which will copy the email text under a particular label, okay, and paste it in the Google Sheets cell wise. So for example, in my Gmail account, I have already mentioned few emails under label known as Airbnb. Okay, I want all the email text data to be imported in Google Sheets. So I'm going to click on extensions first. If you don't know how to implement the script, so this is the way. Go to extensions, open the Google Sheet, go to extensions, click on app script. You will reach this page. You just copy the code, this particular code here, and you can name the code as well if you want. This is a very simple 12-13 line of code which will fetch everything as a text in the Gmail account under Airbnb label. So we have created a function first, get emails. This is customized, you can name it as you want. These two brackets are important. This word function is important. This bracket is important and this bracket is important. So this is a complete set, right? So after this, we are going to create a label under which we are telling Gmail app to get all the user label by name, and the name is Airbnb. My label name is Airbnb. This is a type of method. Okay, it is not custom. It is already saved in Gmail app. Okay, in Google Sheets, in app script, it is already saved. So this complete set is a predetermined stuff by Google. Now I'm going to create a variable threads under which I am calling all the threads in this label. So that means I'm getting all the threads. Thread means I believe you all know that whenever we have a conversation on a particular email, right? For example, you sent an email, somebody replied on it, then again you sent an email, again they replied on it. So that is called a thread. I want the first message in every thread under Airbnb. The question, the target is to get first message in the thread. Okay, first message in the thread. So just keep in mind, because this will help you in creating a right set of parameters, right? So after I call all the threads here, I'm calling a for loop where I know the length of my thread, threads dot, this is the thread, threads dot length. For example, there are 20 threads going on in total under Airbnb. So that means I'm going to loop this particular command, which is my main command. Okay, I'm going to loop this command for 19 times because I'm starting from 0. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 till 19. That means total number of count is 20. Okay, so as we all know that whenever this type of data is stored in this, it is an array, and in coding field, array starts from 0, not from 1. Like for example, in Google Sheet, the index starts from 1, but in coding array, in array, the data starts from 0. That's why we are starting from 0. Now in the main command, we are calling spreadsheet app dot get active spreadsheet, this sheet. Okay, then get a range where column is A. Okay, get a range where column is A, and the number after A is I plus 1. 0 plus 1 is 1. That means I'm telling this spreadsheet app, go to the range which is known as A1. This is the first cell, right? So we have to go there. So it will go there. After reaching that particular spot, this script will set the value, and the value will be set as per this command. This is the command. So what command says, threads I dot get message 0 dot get plain body. I have written here that to get, we are making this script to get first message in the thread. Okay, so first message in the thread means the thread count is calculating as per this I, right? So that's why I have mentioned it here, I. After that, get message. I'm calling get message. So the first message in a particular thread will always be zero because I want the first message. Okay. That's why I have entered zero instead of I. And after that, in that particular message, I want the plain body. So the script will go to this particular cell and then it will set this particular value and it will iterate in all the cells below that as per the count of the messages. So let's start this. So whenever you will first launch this script, it will ask for permission and all. You can give them permission so that you can the script can run, right? If it is not running, then click on run again. So I'm just clicking it on run and we can see automatically everything will get populated in this particular column. So I'll just go through. Okay, it is completed. See, everything is here. So the email is very lengthy. That's why it's coming like this. Okay. If I go by arrow keys, this 3rd, 4th, 5th, 6th, 7th, and it is going down. So for example, there is a scenario that you want some emails, or you can say you want some text here. Okay. You want only those emails which contains Twitter API. So what you can do is bring all the data here and then you can use a rejects formula to extract the information from this particular cell. I hope you understood this video. If you have any doubts, please comment and please contact me so that I can explain you more further. I hope you like this video. Thank you very much.